what I would.
All right, so we're going to have some action happen right here. Who's that?
It's so distracting.
That handsome
action
guy.
Action happened down here on the flat track. Oh, you didn't have to call me handsome.
Oh, wait.
I know you mean it, but you didn't have to say it. Yeah.
Just fishing.
Fishing for, yeah, nothing. Hey, it's been a great first start to this amazing tournament, the Big O, right here in Eugene, Oregon. Couldn't ask for a better venue. Three tracks of action down here, and it's all streaming live.
Or better weather.
Oh, the weather's amazing.
It's usually dumping rain down here. This isn't the way. This isn't the way it's supposed to be.
Light sprinkle of rain down here. It's dumping rain is, yeah, that's where it's actually happening. You guys get the runoff.
It's all downhill from
there.
Yeah,
that's right. Well, south. I mean, it's basic science. You can look it up.
I don't know. It's beyond me.
So, again, the Bay Area Derby Girls taking on the Atlanta Roller Girls. We had a long history of these two teams stemming back 3 years, 2 years from the last time they battered each other. If you weren't here earlier when we were talking about it, Bay Area did come out on top by a substantial lead, 126 points, I believe it was. So we'll see what happens here.
Well, Bay Area is taking advantage of all this extra time at the beginning of the game to chat, have a big group hug, and talk through their apparent strategy. Atlanta, ready to roll.
Poised and ready trackside.
I see handshakes in the captain's meeting. I bet we're started momentarily.
We'll get something going here. You know, it's just that California style. They're laid back. They're hugging
relaxed.
Out, you know.
And Southern hospitality. We'll mix together.
It's going to be a beautiful thing.
I hope so.
A lot of, excuse me, but may I pass?
Right? Excuse me, may I blow you up?
I was looking to get some points. Do you mind if I cut through here?
Coming around here. Pardon me, ladies.
Maybe that kind of Southern hospitality.
Roar, and this is about to get underway.
All right, we got some magic about to happen out here on the flat track.
I see a hand in the air. We are 5 seconds away.
Whistle's blown, action starts. Two jammers on the track right now. Both of them vying for that position. They're looking for the lead jammer. Trying to get out in front of the pack.
Nobody in the penalty box yet. Bay Area up front holding on to things, and it's number 21, Lula Lockjaw, lead jammer.
Lulu Lockjaw breaking out, getting the nod, facing off against number 50, Jammunition. Jammunition still trying to get past that SoCal, Bay Area defense.
Lulu Lockjaw working her way through right now. Nobody to oppose her grabs her points and calls it off.
That's right. Classic hit it and quit it. Get out in front, get those points, and call off the jam. That's going to be four big ones going to Bay Area, starting this off strong. Looks like we might have number 10, Huck Sin, stepping up to the line for Bay Area Derby Girls.
How can you even tell that?
I like to watch TV.
This view is so distracting. And Atlanta holding the front line.
Atlanta's strong four wall, doing an amazing job of holding back that jammer. She looks for the line on the outside, but gets pushed out. Number 10 forced to recycle back behind the pack. It's number 213 for the Atlanta Roller Girls. Aphrodite skates away with a lead jammer status. Number 10 still trying to fight by that Atlanta defense down here, but gets pushed to the inside.
So Aphrodite on her way to the penalty box.
That's going to be a power jam for number 10 for the Bay Area Derby Girls. Huck Sin is going to make the most out of that. Try to increase her lead right here at the start of this game.
And the Anarchy's in from San Francisco.
Demand Araya moving to the outside, getting up in front of that Atlanta defense to try to make a window for Huck in to break through. She gets pushed to the inside, falls down, picks up a cut track penalty.
It's hard to not get emotional about that.
I've got all the feelings. Looks like triple O Demander Riot's going to join her in the penalty box. But it does seem that number 213 Aphrodite did spend that full 30 seconds in the box. That means that Huck Sin is going to have that full penalty as well. Aphrodite's out here now looking to put points on the board, get out in front of that pack, and try to chip away at this four-point deficit that they've gotten themselves into.
Atlanta holding their ground in the back. Bay Area holding the line in front, down one blocker. Aphrodite hits the line, and Atlanta drops in to break things on the inside.
Aphrodite trying to get around that last line of defense, breaks through for five big ones.
Demander Riot back on the track and immediately attacking the Atlanta line.
Huck's in coming in there to get her way back up out of this deficit that they've gotten themselves into after that power jam situation.
And that's jam two. That one was action-packed.
It was. A lot of high-speed action happening out there. 13-8 in favor of Atlanta. We got number 20, Eva Menace, stepping up the line for Bay Area. Facing off by what looks like Choke Cherry out there for Atlanta.
Lines moving forward. Eva Menace working her way around the inside, finding no way through. Choke Cherry jamming
for that Atlanta defense doing an amazing job making her work every inch of the width of this track right now, knocking her down, getting her back up. She's trying to find a window in this armor, but she's going to pick up a penalty and spend the next 30 seconds in the box for Eva Menace.
Atlanta doing a super job just recycling in front of Eva Menace there, no matter who she got by. There were more and more skaters piling up in front of her.
That's right, we look over here and see Bay Area's defense doing an amazing job holding back number 16. Choke Cherry trying to get through for that initial pass so she can put some points on the board. But we got a last line of defense out there. It looks like Murderer Monroe doing an amazing job of holding her back, joined by number 888, Brawlin' Angel.
Choke Cherry back in. Bay Area there to slow her down, but Atlanta swarms them and scrapes off the wall.
Five big points going up on the board for Atlanta, squeaking away at a lead early on in this game. 2020, Ava Menace looking to come back in and try to put some points on the board and chop away at that deficit for Bay Area Derby girls, but that three wall of Atlanta's got a different story.
And again, an excellent job recycling to the front, just getting around Bay Area and staying on her. Dragging her to the very back of the pack right now. Eva Menace starting all over again with the same people hanging out in front of her.
Well, we do have a pack advantage going to Atlanta right now. They've got four defensive players out on the track. Two of Bay Area's were in the penalty box shortly, but now they're being rejoined by 888, Brawlin' Angel.
Door on the inside keeps getting slammed in Eva Menace's face, and she's back to the penalty box for a cut. Atlanta just dogging her through that entire jam.
A lot of aggression happening out there on the flat track. This is exactly what we promised. Yeah. This is exactly what we were hoping for.
I like it.
Hey, they don't come all this way to play hopscotch.
Well, it would be kind of fun.
I'm down with a good game of hopscotch from now on again. Single malt. All right, who do we got up on the line right now? Looks like we're going to have a power start for Atlanta as Bay Area's jammer, number 2020, Eva Menace, is going to be sitting in the penalty box at the start of this jam. Thirty-three Troublemaker being fielded by Atlanta right now.
Demander Riot hanging on just a little bit too long, blocking out a play, and she's on her way to the penalty box. Once again, up front, Troublemaker just powering through.
Five in the sky for Atlanta once again. Pack advantage going to Atlanta as we again have a blocker in the box for Bay Area. Troublemaker just taking the blows, brushing them off. Last line of defense out there, Dolly Rocket trying to hold her back. Takes a knee, has to let her go through. That's 4 points on the board for Atlanta Roller Girls.
It's like Bay Area is just not ready for the assault from Troublemaker when she gets there.
Yeah. Definitely throwing down the offense offensively.
She just, this pass a little slower. They had a handle on her, but before, all over the track, they just couldn't keep track of her. Three of them couldn't hold her down.
Ava Menace getting out and getting that initial pass out of the way. She's ready to put some points on the board for Bay Area. They've got themselves in a little bit of a deficit, 29 points behind right now. There's another 5 points on the board from Atlanta before they call off that jam. Coming out strong. Atlanta has definitely had a promising start in the first four jams of this game. 37-8.
Well, and very different styles of play.
It's that Southern hospitality.
I wouldn't call that hospitality.
That's why they're called the Dirty South, or the Dirty South Derby Girls.
It's a very different kind of hospitality.
Here, let me throw you on the ground and skate on by. Amazing play. Yeah, excellent, excellent aggression coming from both sides. Well, it looks like Bay Area Derby Girls have had to stop and reevaluate this situation. Have a little team powwow.
I was just thinking about what changes are they thinking about right now.
Definitely going to go out and throw the hammer down. Let's see what kind of pep talk they had and how it affects their game. Atlanta's on the track, ready to play. Donning the star for Bay Area. Looks like we got number 61, Pressure Cooker. Step it up to the line. Facing off against what looks like number 50, Jamunition for Atlanta. Whistles blown, action starts. Both of these jammers are trying to fight their way through the pack. We got a strong Bay Area three wall up there trying to hold back Jamunition. Jamunition moving to the outside, not taking no for an answer, dives to the end.
Bay Area definitely setting up a stronger defense at the front end after that break. In the back, we've still got Pressure Cooker trying to break out, and Atlanta holding ground.
Pressure Cooker looking for that window of opportunity, and she finds it on the outside, picking up that lead jammer status for Bay Area Derby Girls. Big nod going to 61.
Jamunition still held up behind that Bay Area wall. And one more to get by. She has to let her go.
Last line of defense out there, Mervyn Monroe lets her go, gets that initial pass out of the way. But in the meantime, Bay Area gets on through for four big points. Number 61, Pressure Cooker, earning her keep. Looks like we got 5-on-4 action happening out there as Atlanta's going to have one of their blockers starting out in the box.
Not for long.
No, she's poised and ready to go, though.
Number 213, Aphrodite, back on the track. And for Bay Area, number
31. Looks like 31 stepping up the line. Frightmare breaking out, picking up that lead jammer status as well. Whatever they had to say in that powwow, we're seeing a lot more aggression coming out of Bay Area in this first half.
Wild Cherry with a good stop on what was that? Frightmare dropped her to the inside and took her to the back of the track. Frightmare having a tough time with the Atlanta line right now.
Bay Area getting into a passive position. I think a Frightmare might push this four wall out far enough to get through.
And Atlanta still doing such a great job of recycling and keeping her in check. She calls it off.
Feeling the pressure.
All day you just see jam kills.
Yeah.
And people have really got that skill locked down.
It's the defense, the level of defense that we're seeing out here on the track today. This level of skater on the track, it's a whole other game.
Number 21, Lulu Lockjaw for Bay Area.
And we are going to field, I believe that's 2-on-3. In the penalty box, this is going to be a power start right now for Bay Area.
Around the outside, Lulu Lockjaw finds some sunshine and breaks out.
Afro Dyke trying to fight her way through as her penalty is up. She's now back out on the track.
Wow, that was an aggressive start for Afro Dyke coming back on. And Bay Area has recycled her to the back of the pack. Jumping in on the outside, Queen Luzia Tifa, who has now switched. Well, Lulu Lockjaw broke right by her. And Bay Area taking this opportunity to put some points on them.
That's right. That's another four-point pass right there for Lulu Lockjaw, working her way through this defense. It's a strong wall out there, though. A lot of them. A lot of hammers being tossed.
Whatever decisions that Bay Area made during the timeout seem to have paid off right now.
Absolutely, they're coming out really strong after that little powwow, but Atlanta's not giving up. They're not letting up at all. Still 11-point lead.
Maybe.
What's that?
A little early for giving up.
Right. Still 11-point lead for Atlanta. They're just trying to hold on to that at this point.
And Aphrodite brought to pretty much a standstill behind the Bay Area wall back there. This is one slow jam.
She's pushing that entire Bay Area wall.
She's so tiny, too. Lulu Lockjaw having troubles of her own with Atlanta up front. She's moving that wall inch by inch. And Bay Area throwing off a skater to go do some damage to try to get her free, and it works.
Jukes to the inside, picks up a five-point pass, going to Bay Area right now. Chipping away at that deficit, only 6 points separate these two teams.
It's number seven. Murder and Monroe dropped in there with all that anarchy and broke up the line, got that Bay Area jammer free. Love when people can walk away from a wall, go do some real damage, and then go right back.
Right. We had Huck Sin stepping up the line once again for the Bay Area Derby girls, the Golden Girls. Facing off against number 16, Choke Cherry, stepping up once again for Atlanta. Huck Sin trying to fight her way through this strong four wall. We got 5-on-5 out there on the track right now. Once I say that, of course, we do have a penalty going to be assessed. Number 89-79, Switchblade Susie.
Huck Sin still up front trying to beat through the red wall.
Getting a little assist right there from number 45, Dolly Rocket, coming in, blowing through, getting Huck Sin out of the way.
Atlanta doing a great job staying with her as long as they could.
She does have that lead jam or not, though, so you can call off this jam at any time.
Choke Cherry still trying to break through the pack.
Getting forced out down on turn three, two, recycled back. I believe that is going to be a star pass. She's poised and ready to take.
It's Dolly Rocket and Demanda Riot in that wall, just all over the place. Got a multiplayer block being assessed on number 247 from Atlanta that slams McKenzie. Yep. And
I believe we're
it's penalties of Rama out there right now.
You get a penalty and you get a penalty.
We're serving cocktails.
Unfortunately, right now, that's a penalty for Huck Sin, which means it's a power jam situation for our new scoring skater. Number 143, baller shot caller for Atlanta. She's Dawn on the Star.
Atlanta, with only two blockers on the track, still throwing everything they have at the Bay Area line. Demanda Riot on the drag back.
Course and her to recycle way, way back behind the jammer line.
And that jam is off.
2 points. Make that 3 points separating these two teams right now. 41 Atlanta, 38 Bay Area, halfway through the first half of this game.
Rough but very technical play going on right now.
Yeah. The aggression is there, but the brains are there too. They definitely know what's going on the track. Good awareness of what's happening all around them.
There's a reason these teams are playing at this kind of level.
That's right.
So it's number 61 pressure cooker.
Facing off against number 6, Wild Cherry. Wild Cherry getting knocked to the outside. She's going to be assessed for a cut track penalty. That means we got a power jam situation in number 61.
That's just what San Francisco is looking for right now.
This definitely could be a lead change right here. 30 seconds, but like we've seen all day,
Atlanta
these power
ready
jam
for
kills.
The attack. Driving the line forward.
Big shoulder being dealt right there by number 76, Queen Luziatifa.
Luziatifa. I swear they make them that way just to mess us up.
That's the whole point. 61 still trying to get through this Trunks two wall. Two skaters holding her back. They got to let her go. That's going to be 5 in the sky. A grand slam right there for the Bay Area Derby girls.
And a momentary lead change. These teams will be trading punches all the way through the end of this jam, which is right now.
And that's going to be another couple points right there for Bay Area, 47-41. Bay Area holds that lead, increases it by 6 points. It's just a small one, but it's enough.
I like this kind of business.
That's right. I love it when they're tight games like that. Points don't have to be high, they just have to be close.
And another timeout.
Currently, WIFTA ranks Bay Area as number 2, as Atlanta number 13 in their rankings.
Wow.
Atlanta's doing an amazing job going up against the number 2 team on the planet.
It is. Odd way to think about it. Here we are sitting in Eugene.
Yeah, right?
Global quality.
I just got done announcing about with a team from Montreal and Helsinki.
Oh, my God. I did Helsinki this morning.
Great. Amazing. Two amazing teams. And, we're in Eugene, Oregon. So. Derby brings the world together.
I hope so.
It's a beautiful thought, right? All right. Looks like we've got pack advantage going to Bay Area right now as Atlanta's got 2 blockers starting out in the penalty box. Bay Area's got 1, so it is a short stack on the track right now.
Number 33, Troublemaker, breaks out and takes lead jammer right away.
But followed quickly behind, we've got number 31 stepping up to the line. What was that, a 21?
It must have been 21.
We'll call it Lulu Lockjaw. How about that?
Although it says...
It is a 31. That's Frightmare. We've got
Frightmare
on the track picking up 4 points for Bay Area.
So if we just say the numbers, we can't be wrong.
Right. All right, we got about 12 minutes left in the first half. Set at 51 points, Bay Area against Atlanta's 45.
Lulu Lockjaw on the track for Bay Area. And number 50, Jammunition, up for Atlanta.
Old jammers, head straight up.
Slow start. A lot of jostling around in there. Jammunition on the outside right now, jockeying to the in. Lulu Lockjaw trying to pry her way through on the outside line. Atlanta holding everything down on her.
Definitely Atlanta's strong four walls doing a great job of holding back that barrier. Jammer is number 50. Squeaks around the outside. Jammunition picking up that lead jammer nod. Looking to put some points on the board for Atlanta.
And it's Queen Luziatifa on the Atlanta line holding everything together.
Bay Area's defense. Bay Area's defense. Seeing number 50 coming up on their 6. Forms up strong to hold her back. reassessing the situation as the blows are thrown. They hold her back enough to make her call off the jam, but not before she picks up 3 points for her team.
51 to 48. Bay Area, still a tight game in this bottom half of the first half.
3 points is nothing in the world of roller derby. That's not even one full pass.
Yeah.
So this is a basically close race right now. 2-1-3 is on the line for Atlanta Roller Girls. That's Aphrodite. Looks like 20-20 stepping up to the line. Eva Menes once again for the Bay Area Derby Girls.
Once again, everybody pretty much bunched up before the pivot line and a slow start. Bay Area out front holding the line and not much progress being made.
Powerful skid. 45 goes in for a hit. Swing and a miss. Number 213 breaks through. Aphrodite picking up that lead jammer status, earning every inch of that. Dodging the blows and getting out in front.
Eva Menes breaks out. She's on her scoring pass.
And Eva Menes does pick up a penalty.
Oh, both jammers picked up penalties. Aphrodite's following her to the penalty box.
And we'll gets have lonely.
The switcheroo, because derby with no jammers, right. No fun.
It's like the Thunderdome. Two jammers enter, one jammer must leave.
Always
right?
Gotta
do that. 2020 breaking through. Getting right up there and getting right out. Getting that initial pass out of the way. Looking to put some points on the board for Bay Area and try to increase that lead a little bit. 3 points is not that comfortable, happy place we like to be.
Dolly Rocket with the great fake out. Didn't buy Eva Menes very much ground with Atlanta line.
Aphrodite right behind Demanda Ryan right now. Aphrodite trying to work her way through this Bay Area defense. But number 45, Dolly Rocket and Aphrodite, Demanda Ryan doing an amazing job holding her back right now.
And Atlanta down 2 to the penalty box right now. Here goes a third. That's going to open things wide up for Eva Menes. And there goes Demanda Riot. They're being too nice to them in the penalty box.
Big shoulder being dealt right there to Eva Menes down on turn number 4.
And that's Wild Cherry playing the role of telephone pole. That was a hit.
She's going to feel that one tomorrow.
Well, she's got more games tomorrow. We'll have to wait until Sunday night.
Rub some dirt on it, get back in the game.
Upper Bay Area, number 61, pressure cooker.
We definitely have a short stack on the track out there right now. 76, Queen is the only one that's out there to hold back. Number 61, and 61 blazes through to pick up that lead jammer status quickly.
It's Choke Cherry out there again for Atlanta. Dropped out and is right now being held to the back of the pack.
All right, we've got a few more skaters joined in the pack. Choke Cherry breezes on by to get that initial pass out of the way. In the meantime, 61 looking to call off the jam before any points are scored by Atlanta.
Baller shot caller with a great hit, slowing down the Bay Area jammer there. Back up for Bay Area, Huck Sin. And for Atlanta, once again, number 6, Wild Cherry.
Both of these skaters vying for position right now to try to get out in front, pick up that lead jammer status. Getting pushed to the outside by number 222, Wild Cherry. Forced to recycle back behind the pack. Floozy doing an amazing job of holding her back right now as she pushes her way through. Last line of defense, number 45, Dolly Rocket, as number 6, Wild Cherry, breaks through to pick up that lead jammer status, but hot on her heels. Bay Area is not giving up that easily.
An attitude adjustment to the penalty box. Both teams down 1.
Huck Sin putting the pressure on her. As this pack speeds up around the track.
It's an old school race to protect your points right now.
This is that kind of action a lot of people like to see. That speed picking up, the aggression happening on the flat track.
Wild Cherry breaks through on the inside, grabs four.
59-56, still sitting on that three-point differential. That's amazing out here on that track right now.
I think we're going to see a lot of that, people running to protect their points if the score stays this way.
Yeah, that's one way to do it.
Number 33, Troublemaker, up for Atlanta right now.
They are coming to a screeching halt out there.
Yeah, this is one of the slowest, toughest games that I've seen in a long time.
It's slow, but there's so much going on.
Yeah.
I mean, we've got a strong 3-0 by Atlanta right now, holding back number 31, Jammer Frightmare for Bay Area Derby Girls. She finally breaks through, picks up that lead jammer status.
8-9, 7-9, Switchblade Susie on her way to the penalty box. Frightmare breaks out, grabs all five. Atlanta down two to the penalty box right this minute.
Frightmare looking to make the most of this power jam situation. The power jam is over, though, as number 33, Troublemaker, is back out on the track. They all go flying off the track down here in turn number two.
Blocking out of bounds called on Atlanta.
We got five in this guy. Grand slam happening right now for number 31. Frightmare, she breaks through this pack to increase this lead Bay Area is trying to hold on to.
Troublemaker breaks out. Didn't get any points for that pass.
To 56 right now. Bay Area sitting pretty. Coming out on top after that jam.
Hey, just a reminder, all of this live derby action brought to you by the one, the only, the greatest there is, Blaze Streaming Media.
That's what you're watching right now, whether you know it or not.
And number 21, Lulu Lockjaw, once again back on the track. And for Atlanta, it's number 50, Jammunition. Lulu Lockjaw powering through, one more to get by. Shrugs it off. Bay Area starts to run up their lead.
They're trying to find that comfortable, happy place where they can kind of ease up a little bit and just play any game. They were fighting pretty hard there for a little while. I don't think they're going to ease up, don't get me wrong.
Just need a little space to be able to play your own game.
Right? A buffer.
Jammunition taking a beating right now in the front of the pack. Right now being dragged to the back. Amanda Wright covering the outside. A low block called on number 888, Brawling Angel.
Lulu Lockjaw finding a sliver-sized crease that she can work her way through on that Atlanta defense. It's a brave way to pick up 4 points on that pass. This is some amazing skating happening by both sides right now.
Lockjaw down low, around the outside, through for another four. Decides to call it off.
Looks back, assesses the situation, calls off the jam.
Just about 2 minutes left in this half. 82-56, Bay Area. I'm excited for what the second half is going to bring. This game could go. Well, anyway.
26 points are the only thing that separates these two teams, and that's not a lot. It's one big jam.
Yeah.
Just aggression happening out there right now as we got number 61 looking to get that window of opportunity. Comes with this big blow happening by Atlanta right now, trying to stop her. 61 being pressure cooker right there for the Bay Area Derby Girls.
Pressure cooker still fighting to break out of the pack. Finally, right at the apex of turn three and four, lead jam.
Choke Cherry still trying to get through that defense. Looks like she's going to get knocked to the outside, forced to recycle back behind the three wall. Bay Area's strong defense doing an amazing job of holding her back right now.
Pressure cooker again up against a really strong wall of Atlanta.
Potassium. They're going to need a lot of potassium.
A lot of that. Yeah. There's bananas like crazy going on.
Definitely.
Right now we're looking at a two-wall game. And drops in number 45, Dolly Rocket, to break up that wall and try to get her out.
She gets pushed to the inside. Number 61 forced to recycle back behind the pack again. Pressure cooker. All that work. Now she's got to do it again.
Boy, that was a huge change, too.
Number 16, Cherry. Choke Cherry.
There's too many cherries in the game.
Too many cherries. Choke Cherry working her way around the pack. End of the jam right there. I don't believe there was a point change.
Atlanta calling for a review right now.
Looks like we got about 4 seconds left in this first half.
Not bad.
I think that you can see that the point difference could be reflected in the amount of penalties that we're seeing on this board. Atlanta Roller Girls, coming out with 20. They're leading on the penalty board. Bay Area Derby Girls picking up 15 in this first half. We can kind of see that in the reflection of points. We got 85 going to Bay Area, who has less penalties than Atlanta, who sit at 56. Penalties don't win games.
No. Penalties just
penalize.
Yeah, it just hurts. Never feel like you're letting people down more with them when you're sitting in the box.
Well, you know, six is okay. Six penalties means you're trying hard.
Yeah, sure.
Seven, then you got to go home, so it doesn't...
Have a nice night.
Yeah, that's too many.
Don't come back.
Yeah. When they actually ask you to take off your gear, you know that you've done a little too much. Yeah.
What? So Atlanta asking for this official review, although we're not quite exactly sure what it was. Wish we had a liaison.
Well, you know, it is the first half. Official review. They got to use it up. Use it or lose it. Right?
Well, use it, but if you win it, you get another. But with 5 seconds left in the half, might as well.
Sure. Let's just throw it in there. Hey, you know what? I'd like to give a quick shout-out to Bont while we're sitting here waiting on this official review. They're lighter, stronger, faster. You can outskate the competition with Bont Hybrid or Vapors. You know, if you want to get that edge up on the opponent, go get yourself some Bont skates. If you find yourself in the Eugene area, don't forget about an LTD. LTD is the best way to connect out here.
Let's see, Lane Transit District.
That's right, Lane Transit District. They're shuttling all of us around from hotel to event center all weekend long.
For free.
For free. You gotta respect a guy that's gonna give you something for free.
Lane County, man.
Eugene. Atlanta's poised and ready to go on the track.
Check us out on Facebook. That's ECRG.TheBigO. Look at the pictures, make a few comments, say hey to your favorite announcers. Because that's all I'm doing it right now.
Right. You know what? I'm on the Twitter. On the
Twitter machine.
Or twitting over here. Hashtagging and whatnot.
Hashtag.
Get your pound on, right? That's what it used to be called, the pound sign.
The pound sign.
It's a big O, so.
Now it's a hashtag.
Whatever. Those old timers, you know. Hashtag, pound sign.
That was when it was on a telephone. Pound this.
That's right. This isn't a telephone anymore, is
no,
it?
No, I don't know what it is anymore.
This has more power than the computers I used in school. It's impressive. And on that powerful device, you too can be following us on Twitter. all of your updates. If you're
machines,
not watching.
I have that one too. Live tweeter tweets.
There we go.
At ECRG. Twitter at ECRG underscore the big O. Hey, it looks like we're getting back to the derby action.
Oh, we got some roller derby. Yeah.
And I'm sure that official review was ended up in some way and a decision was made, and now we're back to play. We've got Lulu Lockjaw back on the track for Bay Area.
And Lulu Lockjaw is going to break out and pick up that lead jammer status in this power start as we have number 16 fielded, Choke Cherry, fielding in the penalty box at the start of this jam.
Baluzzi in on the anarchy right there, opening up the wall for Lulu Lockjaw, getting her down from four blockers to three. Now she's down to two up front.
Oh, big shoulder getting thrown right there. This is a full contact sport, ladies and gentlemen.
Queen Luz Atifa. And Queen Luz Atifa off to the penalty box for that slug.
She is going to pick up a penalty, and Bay Area is going to pick up 5 points on that one.
Number 201, Sweet Cherry Pie, off to the penalty box. Lulu Lockjaw up against three in the front.
Choke Cherry back out there now trying to fight her way through that Bay Area defense.
Lulu Lockjaw doing her very best to fake them to the inside, hold them there, and then sprint for the out. Atlanta not having it.
I'll tell you what, both of these teams are earning their pay this weekend.
Holy mackerel. Right, I thought they were all volunteers.
Well, you're not getting paid?
No.
We'll talk about that later. Anyhow, right now we've got number 16 getting reassessed down here on turn one, trying to get through this strong three-wall defense of Bay Area right now.
Lulu Lockjaw, not liking being dragged to the back of the pack, decides to call it off instead. That's the half.
That is the half right there. End of the first period. We're going to have to take a little intermission, take a little break. I need a nap after this. An amazing first half. We're looking at 95 Bay Area against 56 Atlanta.
And not one of those points was easy for anybody to get.
Hard fought blood, sweat, and tears for every single one of those. But we'll see more action happening out here in about 14 and a half minutes.
Thanks for joining us, and thanks to Blaze Streaming Media for bringing us into your homes or your workplace.
If it wasn't for Blaze, what purpose would I have?
What would the internet be for if it wasn't for watching roller derby at work?
We'll catch you back here in about 14 minutes.
What a treat. You're amazing.
Oh. I don't know. I've got this delay and it keeps throwing me off. Oh. I'm talking and then I hear it. Rah, 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 rah. Wait, but that's me.
They both do that all the time.
It's killing me. Oh, this is good.
It's that, yeah, that little bit of an echo of yourself. Because that's her best.
All right, so getting back to the action down here on the flat track. Halftime is coming to a conclusion. We got a second half happening right here. Looking at what we had in the first half, we had 15 penalties total going to Bay Area against Atlanta's 21. We kind of see that in the score differential, that we've got Bay Area coming out a little dominant on this one. So now we're coming into the second half, and a lot of times second half is a defining factor for those teams.
Speaking of number 21, Lulu Lockjaw, that's who we've got jamming for Bay Area right now, and a low block called. Yes, on number 7 for Bay Area, Murderin' Monroe.
Jammunition putting the star on for Atlanta Roller Girls, coming out strong. I think she came out first, picked up that lead jammer status.
So we got a high block. Not getting up after that.
I believe that was a high block penalty going to be assessed to Jammunition.
She took one right in the face. So what about those stats?
That's right. So we were looking at 15 penalties to Bay Area Derby Girls to 21 penalties. Atlanta Dirty South Derby Girls. We're seeing that reflected in the points. But the highest point scoring skater right now, number 21, Lulu Lockjaw for the Bay Area Derby Girls, happens to be on the track right now. All right, ladies and gentlemen.
Looks like she's back at it.
It looks like she is back up on her feet. This is a full contact sport, and it is displayed in the injuries that these women get. Amazing, amazing athletes, every single one of them.
Bay Area looking for an official review. Just a review.
That's early on in this game. Second half, early on in the second half to be using up that official review. They must be pretty confident about what they're getting.
Well, those stats about trips to the penalty box already out of date. Here we are, all of a minute into the first and the second half. Both teams with skaters in the box right now.
That's right, that's a jammer penalty going to Atlanta as well, which means we're gonna have a power jam situation coming up for Bay Area once we get going back here on the flat track.
And Bay Area's last jammer out of the game at the moment.
At least for the next few jams. I'll bet you when you tuned into Blaze Media or WFTDA.tv, you didn't expect to get tickets to the gun show as the NSOs are throwing it down right there. Big gun show, boom! That's right. It's not just a derby bout, ladies and gentlemen. It's a bodybuilding competition. No, we do have some amazing refs and NSOs out here volunteering their time, making sure that all the derby things do happen.
We could not do it without them.
That's right.
In fact, better than 300 volunteers bring this tournament to you this weekend. Huge crowd of people. Everybody just working for this sport because they love it so much.
Oh, what, you're not getting paid?
Why does that keep coming up?
Checks in the mail, but Emerald City Roller Girls putting on this tournament for us every year. And it's an amazing event. I mean, we have teams coming from all over the planet to be featured right here at the Big O in lovely Eugene, Oregon. Ninkasi Brewing Company is the official beer of the Emerald City Roller Girls. Big sponsor of the Big O. A lot of props going out to them this weekend. Because most people in roller derby like beer.
So that is true. I've noticed that.
It's science. It's a scientific fact.
These things go together. It's not causation. There's no causality.
Well, casualties, maybe. But
casualtism.
Casualtism is correct.
Let's see. What teams came the furthest to be here? That one's actually pretty easy.
I'm going to say Helsinki.
Nope.
We got Australian team
it
here.
It would be
right?
Victorian.
Victoria, that's right. All the way from down under.
All the way.
Shrimp on the barbie.
Down there. Huh?
Hugh Jackman.
That guy. He's actually very tiny. Like the Wolverine.
3.5 feet tall,
very
believe
short.
It or not. Wallaby
would be a great derby name.
All right, looks like we're going to get some action started back out here on the flat track. That's enough senseless rambling.
And enough of those reviews. Let's get this game going.
Right, got to get these skitters warmed up. Number 10, 7 up to the line for Bay Area. Once again, hooks in, donning the star in this power start. Power start because that other jammer is in the penalty box. Hooks in, pushes her way through quickly, picking up that lead jammer status.
Bay Area down one to the penalty box now. Number 247 from Atlanta slams McKenzie on her way to the box. Hooks in, shrugging off hits all the way around the line.
Bay Area throwing on an offensive maneuver right there with her blockers coming in, making a window of opportunity for Hooks in to break through. Huxin finds that line on the outside, wow. Holds it on 1 foot, breaks away for a 5-point grand slam.
And once again, number 50, Jamunition, back on the track from the fresh trip to the penalty box. Finds Bay Area up front with Demanda Riot running the line on her.
Huxin finds a window on the inside, caught him slipping, picks up 4 points. Skating on a post on that inside line.
Jamunition having a tough time breaking around Bay Area's line. Right now she's got Demanda Riot and who is that? Murdering Monroe to worry about.
Looks like Dolly Rocca was assessed for a penalty. She's going to spend the next 30 seconds in the box while the action continues on the flat track. We've got number 50 getting knocked to the inside, forced to recycle back behind the pack. Makes short change of that, gets out, gets through, gets her initial pass out of the way.
And Huxin dropped and dragged to the very back of the pack as well. She decides to call it off before Jamunition has a chance to cause any damage.
But not before she picks up 3 points for Bay Area, thus increasing their lead.
I know. On the line right now, number 33, Troublemaker, and number 61, Pressure Cooker. We've seen these two up against each other a couple of times in this game so far.
Bay Area coming out short stacked as they do have one blocker in the penalty box. She is rejoining the pack right now.
And looks like we are back into these slow starts. Two-wall game. Pressure Cooker working her way around is on her scoring pass. Lead jammer.
Pressure Cooker seeing Mattitude Adjustment coming in for the swing. Jukes to the left, breaks through to get that lead jammer status. Amazing agility on her part. Now she's getting up on the back of this wall, trying to force her way through that Atlanta defense, put some points on the board, and adjust that lead. Right now they're looking at 56 points ahead of Atlanta.
Troublemaker breaks out. She's on her scoring pass, and that jam is off. Jamming for Bay Area, number 31, Frightmare.
Looks like number 213, Afro Dyke, stepping up the line for Atlanta. We've seen this combo before. We've got a short start coming out for Atlanta as they've got their pivot sitting on the bench in the penalty box as the whistle's blown.
Demanda Riot. And Fluzy running the line right now for Bay Area.
Just a lot of power behind that wall as they're trying to push their way through. Number 31 getting forced to the inside as number 213 Afro Dyke gets pushed to the out down here. 31 sprinting her way around the track, but that Atlanta defense comes up quickly, slows her down, but she still gets through for her initial pass. That was an amazing, amazing play.
Afro Dyke, just an amazing skater, really quick on her feet, very quick to fall down, jump right back up. Her lateral movement is super quick, and she's so low in those scrims like that with the Bay Area wall. You could see them all struggling to keep an eye on her and fight her down at the same time.
31 breaking through that wall, putting another 4 on the board.
A low block assessed to Aphrodite.
Got 2-3 now. Atlanta defensive skaters up there trying to hold back number 31. Frightmare, she tries to push her way through. She gets a little help from Demanda Riot breaking up that wall, but looks like Wild Cherry's out there right now to hold her back.
Back block called on number 36, Skaitlin.
31, Frightmare just pushing her way through this wall right now. It's like stepping up to a cinder block wall and trying to walk through it. It's just impossible, but they're doing the best they can right now.
Well, you see Demanda Riot and Fluzy taking every chance they can to break in there, scrape the wall off of them. And one of the things that Atlanta's been best at is recycling back around. As soon as somebody gets scraped off, they're just right back in the front of things.
Looks like we got 5 points getting picked up right there by Bay Area. That was a hard-fought 5 points. You can see the wear on her as she rolls off the track right now. I don't believe she's injured, just a little fatigue.
Number 16 for Atlanta, Choke Cherry. And number 2020, Eva Menace.
This was blown action starts. Both these teams, no, one team. Atlanta's coming out strong with a slight pack advantage as Bay Area was running short, but they have since regained their skater. Now we have a cut track penalty being assessed by Choke Cherry. That gives a power jam situation right now to the Bay Area Derby girls. Golden Girls going to take the most out of this next 30 seconds and try to increase their lead.
They would love to do something with this time, but Atlanta is pretty much busy just saying no.
That's right, walling up and holding them back, trying to kill this penalty.
I think they're doing a grand job of it right now. And that's Queen Luzitifa up front running that line. And she makes it through.
Just spins out.
Hard fought 10 feet.
I forget that I need to speak when things like that are happening because I'm just watching the intensity on the track. And now that she's rounded, she comes right up against the wall.
Doing it right here again.
She didn't get enough the first time. Why not? Just forced. Number 16's current Choke Cherry right now. She's trying to force her way through this defensive wall of Bay Area. Looks like Bay Area's going to peel off one of their defense skaters to go help out. Number 2020, Ava Menace. Ava Menace is going to get assessed a penalty. I believe it's cut track.
Bay Area picked up two right then. One of them on their jammer. Yeah, I think it. Well, there's a blocking out of bounds and a cut. Oh, no, a cut on the other jammer. So we'll see. And take a seat now. Get back on the track.
Right. I want you to have a seat for 1 second and 1 second only.
That's
all right,
really
now
fair.
They're back to fight it out, back onto the flat track. Eva Menace getting knocked to the ground quickly, getting back up, trying to get back into this pack.
And we're right back to Queen Luzitifa running the front line and holding everything down. That jam is off.
I'll bet to a lot of relief of a lot of skaters. I mean, that was a hard-fought jam. Pressure was on.
I need a drink of water. Once again, up for Bay Area, it's Huck Sin.
I believe she's facing off against Wild Cherry from Atlanta. Wild Cherry pushing her way through, but she is going to be assessed a penalty. She's coming out of the gate, picking up a penalty. That's going to be no pass, no penalty going to number 10. She's getting out of the booth too, making her initial pass out of the way. She's going to pick up some points for the Bay Area.
Around the outside, Huxin just gets caught at the last second by number 247. Slams McKenzie, who is now on her way to the penalty box.
And 5 points are going to go on the board for Bay Area.
We're running out of skaters right now. Demanda Riot sweeping the track right there. 247 waved back onto the track because I guess the box was full.
Hunks did get knocked to the outside down here on turn two, forced to recycle back behind the pack. There's only a two wall from Atlanta right now, trying to hold her back. But number 247 comes out of nowhere, swinging a big hit, knocking her to the inside, forcing her to recycle back behind the pack.
And she picked up another penalty on that hit and will be headed back to the penalty box.
And Hunks did also got a penalty. That's so it's going to be power jam going to Atlanta. 4 points on the board right there for Wild Cherry.
Still plenty of action left in the last 20 minutes of this game. Demanda Riot holding the outside.
Wild Cherry just pushing that Bay Area wall out, trying to stretch it out as far as she can.
Right now, Amanda Jamadinha trying to hold the line with Demanda Riot. They have to let her go.
They have to let her go for five. That's 5 big points going up for Atlanta. trying to chip away at that deficit. 74 points separating these two teams right now.
It is. It's just teams slugging at each other to pull off just these 5 points. That's all I need right now.
But I got to say that I've seen it all day long. Chip away at that deficit.
Yep.
A little bit here, a little bit there. Hit it, call off the jam, put those points on the board and keep the other team at zero, and that's how leads are changed.
Are we looking at a straight-up timeout, Atlanta? Nope. There we go.
74 points separating these two teams. They want to stop. They want to have a little chit-chat, reassess the situation, see if they can't make something happen. We do have 20 minutes left in this game, just under that, 18 and a half minutes left. A lot of derby can happen in that amount of time. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I've seen deficits like this melt away.
Atlanta coming out strong in this first half. They put the hammer down and definitely gave it their all. Came out, Bay Area didn't know what to do with themselves, losing the lead to Atlanta, eking their way back, and now they've got quite a substantial lead at 74 points. 74 points not being enough to call it a game yet, but...
No, but some of that was just straight-up penalty trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Atlanta spent a good deal of time in the box. Had a lot of two-blocker starts for Atlanta and a lot of power jam starts.
Well, you definitely don't want to give up a power jam situation to Bay Area. They're going to make the most out of it every time. Looks like we can get Jamunition back out on the line for the Atlanta Roller Girls.
And something else. Now it's an official timeout.
That means it's time for the NSO Gun Show.
Dun, dun, dun. Ba-ba-ba-ba-dum. Bum, bum, ba-dun, dun.
For those of you viewing at home, you're going to miss it because they'd rather show the skaters do things. That's
Gun
ridiculous.
Show. All right, I think we're right back at it now.
That's what the skaters think anyways. Whistle's blown. Action starts. Both these jammers are in full effect right now. Looking for a window of opportunity. That pep talk seemed to do a little something for Atlanta's offense right now. His 50's coming out like an angry chihuahua. Jamunition fighting her way around that track, picking up that lead jammer status.
And that's pressure cooker once again, taking a huge hit from number 76, Queen Luzia Tifa, who is on her way to the penalty box for that one.
She's got to be getting high on those penalties. I've seen her in there quite a few times.
I think so, but that also ended up with putting pressure cooker in the box as well.
Well, we are in a power jam situation right now. It's number 50 rounds the tracks, getting an opposed. That means there's no other jammer out there. Jamunition's looking to put some points on the board. She just has to fight off these defensive skaters from Bay Area.
It's a lot of Bay Area to deal with right now. Number 747. Queasy Kamikaze, Ozzy Kamikaze, Queasy from Ozzy.
Big hit by number 45 right there to Jamunition. Jamunition amazingly holds the line on the inside just as she's rounding the track to get those points on the board for Atlanta.
And pressure cooker back on the track. Right now hanging up behind that Atlanta line. Queen Luzia Tifa. Directing from the inside, making sure to cover the inside line.
Pressure cooker just trying to fight her way through this line right now. Slow walls, slow
forearm. Yeah, slow wall and a big slow forearm called on somebody. 747, that would be Ozzy Kamikaze. She may actually have picked up an extra 30 seconds on that one.
50 getting pushed to the inside once again, forced to recycle back behind this pack. Bay Area's defense just amazing, hitting hard and fast and then reevaluating where they're at on the track, regaining their shape and form and holding back this jammer every step of the way.
And Atlanta taking the opportunity to push up the score, closing up things to 144-84.
60 points.
Put a virtual standstill in Bay Area right now.
Lulu Lockjaw, Donna the Star, once again for Bay Area Derby Girls. We saw her out a few jams ago. She got injured She did get back up, and she's ready to fight it out once again.
And right now it's number 33, Troublemaker, jamming for Atlanta all the way over to the penalty box.
You know what? Maybe they just wanted to greet Lulu back. You know, it's like, hey, let me just let you shine here real quick.
Give her a break. A little bit.
Just a little bit. Just like that, she's going to break through, pick up that lead jammer status.
Atlanta ready for her, but Demanda Ryan busting the wall.
Amazingly, she holds the line after getting dealt a big blow by that Atlanta defense on the inside. They tried to push her in farther, but she stayed on her feet and in an upright position to put some points on the board for Bay Area.
There we go, Lulu Lockjaw right now, pushing hard with one more to get by.
Baller shot caller, last line of defense out there.
And that is Troublemaker on her way back to the penalty box. Honestly, I hadn't even noticed that she was back on the track yet. That was a quick one.
Lulu Lockjaw getting vocal, having her blockers help her out, trying to make a win-over opportunity, but she did get pushed to the inside, forced to recycle back by the pack, right behind number 143, Baller Shot Caller.
It's a pretty consistent stream of whistles going on. We've got Ozzy Kamikaze heading back to the penalty box. 14 minutes left, the way they're racking up penalties, somebody is not gonna stay in the game.
That's right. When they keep stacking them up like that, you can only get 7 penalties before they ask you to leave. They literally tell you to take your stuff off and go home. They don't do that to us. We're okay.
Probably should. Plenty of people wish they could.
That's after we visit the official beer Ninkasi Brewing. Official beer of the Emerald City Rolling Girls. We do have... We do have to keep ourselves in check for that one. All right, stepping up to the line right now. Looks like we're going to have a power slight power start to number 31. Frightmare breaks out early enough to pick up that lead jammer status.
And Troublemaker back on the track after some time in the penalty box. Right now taking a beating from Bay Area's defense.
Wow, the defense for both of these teams has just been impeccable in this game. It just
seems like once they figured it out, they've got you locked down. That's the end of it.
It's almost like that's what happened in the first half. Mm-hmm. Bay Area just needed to see how they're going to play it out, and then they threw their defense out there. And it's been
the first 15 minutes just sort of feeling out what's going on, and then it was over.
Troublemaker breaking through now on our initial pass. That means she could put some points on the board if the jam wasn't called by number 31, Frightmare, before any points were picked up by Atlanta. Huck Sin back on the line for Bay Area Derby Girls. She is not unfamiliar with wearing that star this evening.
No. And that's once again Choke Cherry for Atlanta, number 16. Way up front, Bay Area gets a hand on her. Out she goes, and she'll be escorted to the back of the pack.
Now, Skaitlin with a big push on that one, bringing her out on turn one, forcing her to recycle, giving Bay Area the opportunity to once again pick up that lead jammer status.
Right back in it, and now Demanda Riot, and that's Choke Cherry on her way to the penalty box.
I believe that was a back block penalty.
Wow. Hucks in, bouncing through the pack. Just ricocheted across about 3 players.
31, Erica Baduzzi getting a cut track penalty. She's going to spend the next 30 seconds in the block.
In for the break.
Hucks in, getting pushed to the inside, making sure she doesn't get that cut track penalty called. She recycles back behind the pack before she calls off the jam. Could be because she saw Atlanta's jammer standing up. This is going to give Bay Area an opportunity at a power start, which is going to give them a little chance to pick up that lead jammer status a little quickly.
Atlanta with one in the penalty box. Jammer standing.
And it is going to be pack advantage going to Bay Area as well.
Pressure cooker once again on the line right now. shrugging off hits and taking lead jammer. He's got a star pass to number 23. That's mad attitude adjustment.
Attitude adjustment, Donna the Star being the scorer making skater for Atlanta, but first she's got to work her way through this pack. Bay Area doing an amazing job of holding her back right now. Outrageous defense getting thrown back by the girls in black and gold.
Pressure cooker taking the punishment for all of that right now. Queen Lucy Tifa just really enjoying pushing her to the inside, dragging her to the back of the pack.
Talk about putting it all out there. I mean, over the last, well, the first half and the last 20 minutes, we've seen nothing but hard-hitting action coming from both of these teams. It's a definite testament to the skill level that we see out of the track and the heart that you see in this game.
All day long.
All day long.
10 minutes left in this second half. 171-84 Bay Area. A good solid game being played. All right. So pressure cooker to the penalty box for a back block at the end of the jam.
A little switcheroo there.
Yeah, we weren't expecting that.
Well, that's going to make for a power start for Atlanta.
Atlanta's going
to try and come out strong as they put Jamunition out there to break her way through that two-wall Bay Area, which she does just like that, picking up that lead jammer status.
Slams McKenzie on her way back to the penalty box.
Jamunition trying to fight her way through this Bay Area defense. Bay Area are knocking her to the inside. She's forced to recycle back behind the pack. Looking for a window of opportunity. She just pushes herself right through the middle. Bay Area's got another idea.
Pressure cooker taken to the back of the track and kept there. Atlanta's defense right now. Pressure cooker with a huge push, just moving everyone forward.
In the end, she does get pushed to the inside, forced to recycle back again.
Brawling Angel out there trying to scrape skaters off of her. Also covering the inside line, keeping the pack together. Bay Area slides back, drops in, and they're going to work on scraping Atlanta off of their jammer. That should be happening right about now.
Atlanta breaking through, picking up five big points. It's five in the sky by 50, Jamunition.
Pressure cooker picking up a cut track penalty. A gift from number 247, Slams McKenzie.
That's going to be a power jam situation for number 50 right now. She's going to skate enough post. As in, there's no other jammer out there to put any points on the board, which is exactly what Bay Area doesn't want, but Atlanta is thanking them right now because right now they can put some points on the board and kind of chip away at this deficit.
Jamunition deciding she's tired of all of that, called it off.
I'm tired watching.
Man, I'm exhausted. No, I could watch this for another hour, honestly. Demanda Riot on the line, covering pretty much the entire track. Ready for the assault. From Afro. Nope. I missed who it was. That's number 33, Troublemaker.
Troublemaker does get out, picks up that lead jammer status as number 201, picks up a cut track penalty. That's Sherry, Sweet Sherry Pie.
And there goes the rest of the Atlanta team, the penalty box.
You get a penalty and you get a penalty. Making it rain penalties right here today. All right, number 61 rounds the track on our initial pass. In the meantime, Atlanta racks them up for five big points.
And up front. Pressure cooker finally breaking out. Only two Atlanta blockers on the track right now. Pressure cooker dropped to the inside.
Troublemaker looking to rack up a couple more points. They did break the century mark. Atlanta sitting at 103 right now. Troublemaker getting knocked to the outside, being aware enough not to stand up in bounds. So that'd be a cut track penalty. She recycles back to the back of the pack underneath, behind this Bay Area four wall. Definitely not where I'd want to be.
Pressure cooker definitely right now swarmed by the entire line from Atlanta. Trying to find some sunshine on the inside, and it's just going nowhere. All of this being run once again by Queen Lucia Tifa. She's been an absolute powerhouse all day.
And it moved
the wall. Looking about it, just kind of, yeah, whatever. Hold you down.
This is good. We can do this for a while.
You're not going anywhere.
Pressure
absolute
cooker.
Awareness. She drops in to cover the inside line, and that jam is off.
That was a lesson in defense right there.
Wow.
By both teams. It's not a matter of jamming anymore. It's a matter of not moving at all. Yeah. These walls are just stopping, solidifying, anchoring down, not letting anybody out.
We're going to move forward just enough to not get called on it.
Atlanta did come through, break through that century mark at 106 points. Now they're sitting at a 73-point deficit with 5 minutes left in the game.
On the line, number 6 for Atlanta Wild Cherry, and number 21, Lulu Lockjaw for Bay Area.
Once again, I'd like to give a quick shout out for LTD, the best way to connect here in Eugene, Oregon. They're amazing. Those free trips to and from the hotel to the venue definitely helps us out. We've had a long day of mouthing off at the sports, right?
You caught me pulling a Ted Cruz there, and I had to have a drink. I thought you were going to keep going.
I was waiting for you to take
it. Yeah, thanks. And you all know, hashtag BigO2015. Use that on social media, the internet machine. What's that? The Instagrams and the Facebooks and the tweeters.
The tweeted twitsies.
All of that. Hashtag MVP. Tell us who you think should play on the Big O MVP team against Team USA on Sunday night.
It's going to be an amazing, amazing bout. You got to think about the best skaters from all of these teams ever here going up against Team USA.
That'll be really fun. I actually get to call the junior MVP, junior Team USA team. That'll be I'm expecting quite a brawl.
Again, I'm absolutely loving watching this junior roller derby. There's some amazing skating that's happening out there.
It's just like regular roller derby, only twice as fast.
You can't really call it junior.
No.
I mean, it's just so much more intense.
They're playing at this really advanced level.
No insult to the adults. You know, we try our best, but we're not made of rubber anymore.
Yeah.
And lightning like we were.
Those kids are full of, there's some kind of energy in them that's just not natural.
It's wasted on the youth. Right now we got number 21, Lulu Lockjaw, stepping up the line for Bay Area. She's pushing her way out, picking up that lead jammer status, quickly jumping out in front of this pack.
Oh, she goes on. She's got some new energy in it as well. She's jammed a lot this afternoon and still hitting the line like she means it.
That's right. Come back from injury as well and putting out a show like this.
To the inside. They swing and a miss. You can't slow down the Lockjaw.
She says there's 5 minutes left. It's time to quit playing around.
Yeah.
Let me throw the hammer down and pick up some points real quick. In the meantime, we got Wild Cherry out there doing the best she can to get through this Bay Area defense that's got her locked up down on turn three.
And Atlanta finally got their feet under them right now. Lulu Lockjaw has been slowed down. And we're back to a two-wall derby. Atlanta sends one to the penalty box. Lulu Lockjaw with two more to get by.
Lulu Lockjaw getting knocked to the outside down here by the pivot line. She's feeling that pressure. Calls off the jam, says enough is enough.
Calling it.
Pick up a few more points. Bay Area still sitting at 188 to Atlanta's 106.
Hucks in back on the line for Bay Area.
Facing off against number 50, Jamunition for Atlanta. Atlanta's coming out short stacked. We've got two skaters fielded in that defensive position.
Ooh, and Bay Area throwing a bunch of real heavy hitters at the line.
Well, I mean, they are two blockers, but one of them's Queen Luz Yatifah.
Yep.
Yeah, so that's more like six. She's been doing an amazing job this whole game.
Hucks in, breaks out, calls it off because the pressure was on from Jamunition.
So right now it's a waiting game. I mean, we've got 82-point lead by Bay Area with 2.5 minutes left, just a little over 2.5 minutes left. Bay Area plays it smart. They can slow down the clock a little bit and see if they can run down that time, or they can say, you know, to heck with it, let's make some points and have a game.
Keep playing.
Yeah.
Don't stop on my account.
You got to give them a show.
Atlanta with one blocker left on the track. But as we said, well, there was no stopping that.
Number 31, Frightmare, hop, skip, and a jump. Sees that one blocker out there and says, I'm going to go.
And now Atlanta with two blockers in play. Frightmare slamming her way at everybody ahead of her. Picks up a forearm and is on her way to the penalty box.
So it looks like we're switching seats here. It looks like Atlanta's now in the power jam situation, putting five on the board by number 50. Also, we've got two blockers in the box for Bay Area as well, so we're short stacked out there as far as defense goes. So that's going to give an amazing power jam situation to Atlanta right now as number 50 rounds the track once again for another five-point pass.
Jamunition shrugs off that hit. All the way through for five more.
That is a big jam right now for Jamunition.
Boy, she is really, yeah, making a lot of trips.
15 points before she gets knocked out finally by Bay Area.
Frightmare back on the track. And up against that Atlanta wall in the front. Throwing a lot of action at it. And a multiplayer block called on Queen Luz Yatifah. I wonder if some of these names aren't lost on me because I don't translate them with the Southern accent.
With a dirty South Derby name?
Yeah.
Number 50 fighting through that Bay Area defense to pick up another 4 points, four on the board for Atlanta as number 31 fights off the ATL defense down here, pushing her around to the inside. She still picks up 5 big points before the end of that jam.
30 seconds left in the game. 201, 125, Atlanta with a big jam, that last jam.
That was a big jam for Atlanta. I believe she picked up almost 20 points, 19 points or something. Maybe.
What? Yeah. I don't
know. I wasn't counting. 201 for Bay Area, though. They did break the double century mark on that jam as well. So.
And we're looking at timeout, Atlanta.
Because why not?
One extra jam.
Yeah. Hey, during that timeout, I'd like to give a quick shout out to Notorious R.E.D. Notorious Gear Deodorant by Notorious R.E.D. Smell clean even if you play dirty. Picks them up at Fast Girl Skates. And I'll tell you what, I got a couple Derby girls in my household, and I absolutely love this stuff.
Yeah, it makes the world smell good. Because Derby gear makes the world smell bad.
You know, I gotta say, I love them, but they stink.
Oh.
Derby's a beautiful sport until you smell their pads.
I don't know what the conditions are like with your league where they practice and play, but in Portland, we basically play inside of a great big metal can.
Yeah. Sweat box.
40 or 50 sweaty women and their gear, and that place smells. And I love the Notorious R.E.D.
Well, this looks pretty even out there, huh? Looks like we got Bay Area's gigantic, strong wall of black and gold facing off against number
Atlanta's
six.
One.
Wild Cherry.
You know, one is all they need.
Yeah. Well, with shoulder hits like that, it is, but she shrugs it off. Lulu Lockjaw breaks through to get that lead jammer status in this power start.
Queen Luz Utipah back on the track, and now there's two, and that is effective.
That is effective. She gets knocked to the inside, forced recycle back behind. We got Aphrodite up there trying to fight her way through that last two remaining skaters for the Bay Area defense, which she does to get that initial pass out of the way.
Lulu Lockjaw right behind her decides, why not call it off? That's the end of that game.
Period clocks up. Yeah, let's give it a call. That's 205 Bay Area to 125 Atlanta.
Unofficial.
Unofficial, of course, but it was a hard-fought 205 points. It's a hard-fought 125 points. Both
yeah,
these
another
teams.
Really remarkable game.
She's just putting it out there. A lot of defense, heavy-hitting offense. Waiting for that official nod from our officials.
Officially.
Officially, waiting. Officials. That is the final score, ladies and gentlemen. 205 Bay Area to 125 Atlanta. Bay Area coming up from Oakland, throwing the hammer down and showing them what they're made of here at the Big O.
And that's that. Hey, one more time, we want to thank Blaze Streaming Media, bringing all of this action right to you, right at home, including me, Magic Pony Power Hour.
And me, the Norwegian Persuasion.
My favorite so far today. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it.
Hey, tune in for more. We got Big O happening here for the next 2 days. A lot of action happening on both tracks, 1, 2, and 3. Amazing Derby happening from all over the planet right here in Eugene, Oregon. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching.
We're done. Hey, thanks.